whispering. I'm at work right now. But it turns out the walls in the office are thin and my boss could hear me. So I'm on break. But I'm gonna start reading. I'm thinking of ending things. And for some reason I'm too self-conscious to actually speak normally. So I'm whispering. So I'm gonna start reading this book. I'll tell you about it. I might spoil stuff. I'll let you know if I spoil things. But yeah. So I'm gonna read this and then watch the movie later. And I wanna know which one's better. Alright, see you soon. Okay, so I just got home from work and I'm about to start a 3-hour class, so I'm not even going to be reading the book. And I didn't get that far into it, just 25 pages. But to be honest, I don't know what the main character's name is. I don't even know if they said her name. But it's this girl and this guy and they're together. But it seems like she wants to break up with them, but they're still like doing it or whatever. And they're going on a trip somewhere to go see his parents. And they're having dry ass conversations. Like, I don't know why they're with each other. Like, their conversations are hella boring and she doesn't even find him like attractive. It's weird. But I'm on page 25. There's also like, I'm spoiling. This is gonna be a spoiler vlog. There's also like this person, like she assumes it's a middle-aged man. So I'm gonna say it's a middle-aged man. Just like, blowing up her phone at like midnight, but then hanging up if she answers. And he'll only leave a voice message when she doesn't answer. And it's weird and creepy as shit. The scenes are going from current day to like the past, how she met her boyfriend, and then also like some creepy ass childhood memory she had. And I don't know if I'm liking it. Like, it's a fast read. But I don't know. I'll let you know how it's gonna go. But I do feel like the movie would probably be better. Is that rude? I'm only on page 25. We'll see how it goes, okay? But yeah. Well, good morning. It is currently, let's see what time it is. 3:42 a.m. and I can't sleep, so I decided why not use this time to read a little bit. My alarm clock goes off at 7 for work, and I'm probably, if anything, I'll probably go to sleep at like 5 and then wake up at 7. So I'm gonna start reading, and what I do now is I put on reading sprints in the background because for some reason it helps me focus. So I'm watching a past live stream from How to Train Your Gavin, and yeah, I'll give you an update later on. Okay, so I am now on page 55, and then I have a few tabs in here, mostly like quotes that I like. I don't really know how to describe what I feel about the book, because in my head I'm like, the conversations that Jake and this girl are having aren't really that interesting, but I'm just curious to know what happens, because before each chapter there's like a single page of a conversation of an event that happened, and it seems like it's a tragic event. So I want to know what's happening because I think it involves the caller. So right now it's currently 4:26. I think I'm gonna try to go to sleep, and if I wake up at 7, maybe I'll read some more. If not, I'll bring the book to work and I'll read more at work. So yeah. I finished the book, and the movie is supposed to be 2 hours long. I did not like this book. I gave it a 2-star for effort, okay? Because it's not a 1-star, but I was looking at reviews and people wholeheartedly, with their chest, gave it 4 out of 5 stars. And I don't want to shit on those people, but I don't. 2-hour movie, okay? Half of this book were spent in a car with Jake and this girl that has no name. A chapter of the book, because I already said I was going to spoil this, a chapter of the book is like being with his parents and having like an awkward fucking dinner thing. The rest of the book is like them going back to their home and end up at a fucking creepy school, and it's supposed to be like suspenseful and all this other shit. And then the twist happens, and then it ends. People are saying in reviews that this could be an A24 horror movie. And I get it. I do. I understand. But oh god, I have to sit and watch this movie. No, it's fine, because I said book versus movie. So if the movie's worse than the book, I don't know. Because it's on Netflix. It says it's like 2 hours 14 minutes. And I said I was going to spoil this. So think of it as like if you watched the movie Split. And our boy James McAvery, I hope that's his name, I always forget his last name, had multiple personalities. So it makes sense why we never know the girl's name, because it's like Jake. The girl is Jake. Like another personality or imaginary friend or whatever. I don't know which one it is. But at the end, it's implying he commits suicide. I didn't. And I have to watch this movie. And I'm debating if I even want to watch it today. Like, fuck. Okay, this book's a 2-star. I'll talk to you after I watch the movie. Because I was going to do, like, me watching the movie and then, like, reactions to it. I think I'm just watch the movie and then get back to you, because fuck, I don't want to watch it. Oh no. Fuck it. Okay, I'm gonna get back to you. Bye. Okay, so it's 2 hours later and I finished the film. The lighting's off because it's dark outside and now I'm using a lamp. But the movie also gets a 2-star. Do I feel bad about this? Kind of. The movie would have got a 3-star if it wasn't for the last 20 minutes. I want to make that clear because the last 20 minutes were just confusing. So, there's a lot of differences from the book to the movie, especially the pacing and the dialogue. So, the beginning half of the book, it's them in a car talking, boring monologue, because it's not actually them having a conversation, it's her having inner monologue. And we get those scenes in the film, but it's less than that. It's like less weight, like dial down. And you get like pretty photography shots or photography filming while she's talking. And then they added more conversation, which was cool. Because if you add all the actual dialogue between characters in this book, it's probably like a chapter, like a few pages, and not the whole thing. So in the film, the whole movie is basically dialogue, actual conversations, and then there's like some monologue scenes. Now, my favorite scenes are the ones that are actually in the parents' house. One, it's longer than the book, and there's more stuff added. But it's not as suspenseful. Like, in general, the movie's not as suspenseful or thrilling as the book. So, I want to knock. So, if you think you're going to watch a thriller going into that, it's not. But if you think this is a movie where it makes me feel dumb because you have to think more deeper than what it's showing on the surface. So, in reality, yes. I know it's going to be scary because it's like, it's a film about growing older, becoming lonely and isolated, and then having somebody develop schizophrenia. And I believe this could be a wrong interpretation of the film, is that we're in older Jake's memories and he's a custodian who is older. And in the book they mention a custodian, but it's all the way at the end, so you don't really think about it, but you know, like, he's the person making the calls on the phone. And they only talk about the phone calls, not even briefly. They mention it like twice, and she gets the messages, and the voice on the phone talks hella fast, and you're like, what's happening? But you become these characters, which is like a 40-year-old Jake? Maybe like between 30 and 40, Jake, and then like this girl who has a name in the film, but when you read the subtitles, because I watch everything with subtitles on, it's like unknown girl or unnamed girl or some shit like that. And but in the film they give her two names, so it's Lucy and Lucia, something like that. And to me, it's older Jake, who's now like 70s 80s, having these memories, like flashbacks, what he's thinking inside his head of him being younger, and it's like having conversations with your inner dialogue. So if you ever seen Bo Burnham's skit where it's left brain, right brain, it's kind of like that, but it's like your different personalities talking to each other, or like your inner thoughts talking to each other. But we're going down like memory lane of Jake in his old house with his family, showing around like an ex-girlfriend or like an old girlfriend, past relationships. But also there's like scenes where it doesn't feel like they're dating. It's like him talking to himself, which is, I don't know how to explain it, but that's how it is. And it's not as creepy as the book, as I mentioned, because even though it says tense music, it doesn't, the filming process or like the acting doesn't intensify where it, I feel like it should be tense where the book was. Like, I felt scared reading, I didn't feel scared. I know where it's supposed to be tense and like fucking suspenseful. In the film, that's not what it felt like. It just felt like some weird shit's happening. Let's play tense music. And you notice that scene when two things happen. So she's walking around the house and she's looking at pictures, and she sees a picture of herself as a kid. And then Jake is like, oh no, that's me. You don't see the resemblance. But in the book, you find out that this person, this girl, is Jake. So I was like, oh, that's the first time acknowledging it. That makes sense. The second time is when they're at the dinner table and the father, or she's describing how they met each other, and the father is like praising Jake for manning up and like hitting on a girl. But when he's like, well done, Jake, or when he says that line or some shit like that, he looks at her instead of Jake, the male character. And I'm like, oh, I seen that. So she goes, to answer a phone call or check her messages, and when she turns back around, this is when it gets like the weird part. Everyone disappears. Like during this house, you see things like appear out of nowhere and then disappear. And then when she goes upstairs to go find Jake, like on the doors, there's like little notes, and one says like Jake's room. So she goes there and it's like his childhood room. The father comes back in, but he's older now. And then when like, you could see them get older and then younger because it's like different memories that he's having. And I was like, okay, that's kind of cool. But then when they leave the house, they're in like a snowstorm, like a blizzard, and they're having like this conversation. This is when it kind of gets like to the boring parts. Some things are interesting. So the boring part was like, they're having like this conversation and sometimes it sounds like nothing. And then they drop like these actors who are playing this role who have different disorders. And one of the actors is like schizophrenic. And I was like, oh, okay, I see what you're doing. And then they drive up and then they hit like, in the book, they go to Dairy Queen, but I guess you can't trademark that in a movie. So they call it something else and they have like a little theme jingle song. And they go there, and this is when you find out, oh, something, this is like your, you know, this person's, the girl is Jake. So they go to the ice cream shop, and they have it also in the book, right? But in the book, Jake's the male character. His personality is more like controlling, and it's like, oh, I'm gonna handle everything. So in the book, he goes up to the register and talks to the people. But in the film, it's actually the girl, because the male character, Jake, is like, they're gonna laugh at me, you need to do it because they don't like me, or something like that. So she goes up, but they're ignoring her. Two of the workers are ignoring her, but they're staring at Jake, who's in the background. And then out of nowhere, this other worker comes out and is like making the ice cream for them. And then that character's like having like some weird monologue, like she's scared for her and all this other stuff. But when you look at the film itself, she Jake, the girl who is unnamed, she looks at the ice cream lady and she has like scars and stuff on her hands and like burns and rashes, and she's like questioning why that's happening. But when Jake goes, the male character Jake, this is going to be so confusing, the male character Jake goes to where she's at and grabs the icy or the blizzard snow cone thing, whatever, milkshake, and you could see they have the exact same scars and stuff. But in the car, they're like, you didn't see that? And he's like, no, I wasn't paying attention, basically. But he was like observative through like other stuff earlier on in the film. And I was like, so the ice cream person was another like personality or whatever of Jake. So then they like go and drive, they get caught in a storm, and then they go to the school. And it's semi how it played out in the book. Like, actually it's not. There's like certain things where it's like, oh, that's the same, and then it completely changes, because I'm happy I said I was gonna spoil this. So we go there, this is where it's supposed to get tense, and you're supposed to feel like the girl is about to die because she's searching for Jake. But when Jake finally leaves her in the car in a blizzard to go handle, like to go beat some guy up that was like watching them make out in the car, I feel like it's gonna sound weird because I didn't mention that in the book. But yeah, so basically they stop at the high school to throw away the milkshakes or whatever. And then Jake fucking ends up trying to do it. He's trying to have sex with her in the car, but then he sees somebody looking at them. And when that happens, he gets upset and mad, and then he leaves to go basically fight somebody, right? So he enters the school and he's there for hella long, and she's like, what's happening, blah blah blah, and she goes inside, and that's when it's supposed to get all tense. But in the film, that's totally different. It's he leaves her, and then she has, there's a section where she's talking to herself and arguing with herself out loud. And I was like, oh, okay, what is happening? And then she leaves, goes inside the school, and it's not scary because you could see the janitor or the custodian like mopping, and like this is the person you see pop up throughout the whole film. And I was like, okay, because in the book, like, she runs away from them, and there's like this whole like scary scene, right? But this one, she's like talking to herself, and then he sees her, asks like, hey, are you okay? And she's like, have you seen my boyfriend? And he's like, what does he look like? And she's trying to describe him, but she can't. And then they like end up hugging or whatever. And then this is where it gets weirder, because then they have a fucking ballet dance scene, like a contemporary dancing. And it was beautiful. I could acknowledge that, but I don't like that it was in the film because it didn't feel like it fit with the film. So in the book, they have the suicide, quote unquote, right? And it's supposed to be like the scary thing. But then you have this ballet in the film, and it's not scary. It's actually filmed beautifully. So it's basically Jake and this girl. And then there's, I don't know, or two younger versions come. And then they start dancing, and it's nice. And then you're like, okay. And then it's like it's like 3 to 5 minutes long. And then the custodian comes out and fights younger Jake while they're doing their ballet scene. And then he gets stabbed and all of this. So then after this ballet scene, they have the older janitor custodian, who I believe is Jake, right, go to the car. He's having hallucinations and he's looking like past his, like through his life, and then like he sees this fucking pig and it's like telling him what to do, and he follows the pig down the hallway, and you're like, what the fuck is happening? Because now he's like butt naked and all this other stuff. And then after that, we get a fucking musical with the Jake who's like 40 years old, but then they have him in ugly ass makeup that's supposed to make him look grown, and then the camera panders to the audience, and everyone in the audience looks so gross. It's so, like, I hate it. It's like the makeup is so gross, and then how, like, ugh. And then it's a musical, and then it ends on this musical, and I'm like, what? What just happened? It felt, the last 20 minutes felt like a whole nother movie, and that's how it ends. So the book and the movie are both a 2-star. But I think the movie was better than the book. That's what I'm going with. The movie was better than the book to me. I would like to know if anybody's seen the movie or read the book, what they think. Because I'm curious, because there's a lot of 4 to 5 stars for the book. And then I think the movie's sitting on at least Letterboxd at like a 3. So yeah, it's a movie and a book that you have to like think deeper about. But yeah, if you like the video, like the video. If you want to comment, comment. If you want to subscribe, subscribe. I'm not here to tell you what to do. But if you do have like a video, if you do have like a film or a book that you want me to read and then watch the movie, just comment down below and I'll try to do it. All right. Hope you like the video. Bye.